happening. No gunshots, but they getting.
Hey, what's up, you guys? Craft Farms here, and welcome back to another video. Today we are back here on Dakota Plains. Today we are going to be fertilizing some of these fields that we planted, so that way we can get a good yield. So we got the Oliver 1955 hooked up to the sprayer already. We're gonna unhook that for a second so we can remove these duals. And now we are ready to rock and roll. We are going to snap a screenshot first here. And now we are ready to rock and roll. So, I'm going to be doing the review or the showcase, whatever, on the Case 4540 Titan Spreader. That is going to be going up at the same time as this video, so be sure to go check that one out as well, and check that mod out. It's definitely worth taking a look at. How low does this go when I drop it? We'll leave it lowered then. Alright, so we're gonna start at the farthest field here. Go ahead and get unfolded here and get spraying. I won't need to use GPS with this. I can just drive free-handed. Man, this thing is huge. Oh, forward. Okay, we gotta hurry up and take this screenshot here. Make it so I'm running a little faster here. There we go. We got that screenshot. Can I do this in cab as well? Maybe. We'll find out here. No, I can't. I'm kind of messing up here. So it shouldn't take really that long to do all of this spraying, because we can go at a pretty fair speed, and then this thing takes out a lot of area, so. So hopefully we get a good yield after all of this spreading, especially because it's going to cost us a lot of money to do all of this spraying, not spreading, I don't know why I said that, but it's going to cost a lot of money to do all of this work. It already has, and it will continue to cost quite a bit yet. Because we're not done. I'm sure we'll have to fill this maybe once or twice yet. So, you know, there will be a few thousand dollars, and we only have a couple thousand, so I'm willing to bet that we'll be in the red come harvest time, but because it'll be happening at harvest, or, you know, around harvest time, I'm really not that worried about it, because at that point, we'll be making money. You know, I would definitely like to wait for a great demand, but you know, we don't have the money to sit and be fast forwarding time a bunch to find a great demand because of all of the maintenance that we'd have to pay on all sorts of different, you know, all of our machines. So to sit and pay all of that would not make it worth it. So we'll just, you know, find the place that's paying the most for whatever crop we're selling at the time. We'll get both the trucks hauling. You know, I'll drive the one truck and put the other one on Follow Me Mod. And then we can go to whatever elevator's paying the most and, you know, make some money. Which is something that we definitely need to do. Really don't need to upgrade much of anything. Turn it off. Really don't need to upgrade much of anything. I would like to maybe look at getting like a grain cart. Maybe like the Unverfirth grain cart. Or I have a John Deere 650 grain cart that I am bringing down from FS17. I think it was possibly in 15. Or in 13 or something like that, but I saw it out for 17, so I just downloaded it and started working on it. I think I have it in Blender with all the textures applied. I just need to like center a couple of things, and I hate when it does this. I need to update my graphics driver again. I'm sure that's probably why it's doing that. I don't know why it does it, but all I know is it's annoying. So we can be able to knock all this out in one pass. Sweet. That'll work out. Perfect. Might miss little snippets here and there, but nothing too major. So that's one field done. So we'll start on this large one. I think it'll be only like two videos of spraying or something like that. Actually, we're going to go start on the other small one here. We're going to go start on the cornfield is what that is. Because that is... What is that one again? Map. That is not alfalfa. That is rye oat. I can't remember now. What the heck did we put there? I think rye. I don't know why. I don't even remember it. And then corn, and then sunflower, and soybean. I don't know why I can't remember what we put in there. I'm pretty sure it was rye. I don't think I did oats. I guess we'll find out come harvest. I could also go back and look, I guess, to figure it out, but as far as I know, it's rye. I don't think I did the oats. Actually go like this just to make it look like it's unfolding. For screenshot purposes, of course. We're gonna drop it almost all the way. And we're under 10 minutes yet. So the next video we'll probably be able to start harvesting. At the rate that we're going. Sprayer really doesn't get dirty that fast. I've noticed that previous times that I've used it, that it just Doesn't really get dirty that fast. But it's not, you know, it's just kind of following behind the tractor. It's not really in the ground, so that must have been a you not own this field instance there. I always hate when those happen. It did kind of kill our bank account to lease this field, but we are able to put in extra crop, and that means extra money. It'll be nice in the end, especially because that's one payment for 30 days, and in 30 days, we can do a whole lot of harvests off this field. I mean, in one harvest, it'll pay, you know, we'll get enough money from our crop to have leased this field, probably to have even bought in this field, really, you know, we'll have probably earned enough money for that, so, or in two harvests, something like that, you know, it just, you know, we'll have gotten a lot of money off of this field in the end that, you know, paying that one thing every 30 days won't kill us, and then being able, you know, we can go back and buy it eventually too. You know, I'd like to buy it fairly soon, because the sooner that we can buy it, that means less payments, you know, less lease payments that we need to make on this, which means the less money that this field's going to cost. Because, you know, if you add, you know, this, let's see, because this field to buy, field 30 is 51,000. So, you know, if we lease this like 12 times, that'd be our 50,000 there. You know, which I highly doubt we'll be doing it that many times, but, you know, every single time that we have to lease it, that's another $4,000 that this field's costing. So, like, now, you know, if we bought it right now, this would cost us almost $5,600, you know, when you think about this lease payment for it. So, you know, and then we'll probably end up leasing it maybe one more time. So, you know, that'll be almost $60,000 for this field. So, you know, it's another $8,000 to $9,000 extra for this field that, you know, if we didn't have to pay it, would be awesome. I need to start posting some of my screenshots. I haven't posted a screenshot in a long while, so I need to get posting. My Instagram and Facebook page have been kind of dead. And so has my YouTube. All of my social medias have been pretty dead aside from, you know, yeah, everything, I guess. Aside from me being, like, using it, but not posting anything to it. So, yeah, we're going to have to refill here pretty soon. I actually got a lot of ground covered with just this one tank, so I think we'll have to fill it one more time, maybe, to be able to cover that field. But even in doing that, we'll be able to cover a lot of ground in with this little amount. So we'll just run back here and go refill. Take this nice long drive. Then we can drop that all the way. I suppose there's a bit of a hill there, that's probably why it kind of slows everything down a little bit. But really, that shouldn't do much. Floating tree. I mean, that hill there isn't very big. Got a little bit of dirt on the sprayer there. Holy smokes, this is taking a lot of money. Gonna show me $1,123 to fill this thing. Yikes, so if we have to refill it completely again, we're gonna be nearly broke. Okay, I need to reply to this message really quick because this is absolutely ridiculous. There we go. Oh my goodness, this is ridiculous. Somebody messaging a page that I'm part of, asking if if any of us make mods, and yet didn't even look at the page. It's ridiculous. Oh, I made it to this one. And, a little bit light there. So we'll be able to get this field finished for sure, and then we'll be able to start on the next field already in this video too. So the next video will finish spraying and get ready to start combining. We'll actually probably be able to start opening a field or something. I'm just thinking we got maybe like two more passes left on this field. Maybe a third pass, clean up a little snippet. I do like the looks of this sprayer though. It's just a reskin that I found of the in-game Amazon sprayer. It was released. I have no idea where, but it was released. I know that. But it was released. It's just a little reskin. That's all that it is. It's not something scratch made by somebody or anything. But it's very nice for being just a reskin. And we'll have one more pass left. Almost done. Definitely feels nice to be making videos again and getting back into playing again. And also working on projects. I definitely missed that. In a way. And in a way, I did not miss working on projects at all. But I mostly did. The reason I don't is just because a lot of times it's a headache. That telephone pole for a second. Alright, starting on the final field here. Ugh, got all kinds of overlap going on here. Trying to position a screenshot and just completely driving wonky. The downhill part of this field is nice. The uphill part, not so much. But with the sprayer, it shouldn't, the tractor shouldn't pull as hard going up the hill as it did with the planters. Auto save. There's the little spacer between the two crops in this field, the sunflowers and soybeans. It is still slowing down. It's not slowing down that bad though. Not as bad as it did with the planters. It's definitely slowing down. That's for sure. There's no doubt about that one. Another 5 minutes. Yeah, we're gonna get a fair amount of this field started too, even. So it won't take long in the next video, and we'll be able to finish it up and then fast forward some time and get it moving. I think I did two or three headlands on these fields, and this sprayer is covering both of those in one pass. It's insane. I think it was three. Yeah. It was three there. Yeah, three here too. At three headlands. This thing's covering them in one. It's crazy. Okay, we can start going up and down now. I need to take that compass mod out. That thing's annoying. Really, it has no use to me. There's kind of a compass thing on the PDA too. In a way, I think that's what that is. I don't know. I don't really care either, but it has no use to me, so I don't have any use at all for a compass in a game. It wasn't quite half, but it's close enough, I guess. It's good enough for me. I'm no perfectionist by any means. Well, some things I'm not. Other things, kind of. But most of the time, not. So, yep, we're getting close to having to refill here again. Actually, that's just what I'm going to do. So, okay, I think I'm going to end the video here. I think I'm getting close to my time anyways. Yes, I am. So, that is going to do it for this video, guys. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to hit that thumbs up button. If you're new to the channel, welcome to the channel. Be sure to subscribe if you like what you see. Be sure to turn on the post notifications to be notified every time I upload a new video. Be sure to check out down below in the description for my PC specs, my upload schedule, as well as links to all of my social medias and some other cool YouTube channels that are worth taking a look at. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get this thing refilled, get it back to the field, get it set up and ready to rock and roll. And then in the next video, we'll finish up the spraying and we'll probably get started on combining, or else get ready to start combining. And then, so that'll be what we're doing in the next video. So be sure to go check out the video of the showcase on the 4540 Titan spreader as well. And yeah, as always, guys, thanks for watching, and we'll see you tomorrow.